Welcome to an example on how to graph a parabola when the vertex is at the origin. In this example, we want to graph 10y equals x squared and find all these key characteristics of the parabola. Because this is our first example, let's review the definition of a parabola. A parabola is a set of all points that are equidistant from a fixed line called the directrix and a fixed point called the focus. So looking at our graph, this red horizontal line is a directrix, and this black point here is the focus. So every point on this blue parabola is equidistant from the line and the point. So this distance is equal to this distance, this distance is equal to this distance, and this distance is equal to this distance. And this would be true for any point on the parabola. But when it comes to graphing the parabola, the key distance will be the distance from the vertex to the directrix, or this distance here, as well as the distance from the vertex to the focus, which we know would be the same. So if the equation of the parabola fits this form here, where the x term is squared and the y term is to the first power, the parabola will always open up or down. If a is negative or less than 0, the parabola will open down. Or as pictured here, if a is positive, the parabola will open up. So let's take a look at our sketch for a moment. First, if the equation fits this form, the axis or axis of symmetry will always be the y-axis with the equation of x equals 0. And then by determining the value of a in the equation, notice how we can determine the distance from the vertex to the directrix, as well as the distance from the vertex to the focus. It's going to be equal to the absolute value of A, which will help us find the equation of the directrix as well as the coordinates of the focus. And then this green segment is called the latus rectum or focal diameter. Notice how it has a length equal to the absolute value of 4A, and this segment is parallel to the directrix, passes through the focus, and has both endpoints on the parabola. So this segment here is going to help us make a more accurate sketch of our parabola. Notice how the focus is also the midpoint of the latus rectum or focal diameter. So there are some notes here that we can use to find the key characteristics of the parabola, but I think if we understand this geometry here, we don't have to memorize this information. So looking at our example, let's go ahead and change the order of this equation so it fits this form perfectly. Meaning we can write this as x squared equals 10y. And again, because the x term is squared and the y term is to the first, we know the parabola is going to open up or down. And because it's in this form, we know the vertex will be at the origin. So the vertex will have coordinates 0, 0. So now let's determine the value of a so they can find all the other characteristics of our parabola. So looking at the form of the equation, notice that 4a is equal to positive 10. So 4a equals 10, divide both sides by 4. Notice how a is equal to 10 fourths or 5 halves, which is also equal to 2.5. So because a is positive, we know the parabola will open up. So to start, let's go ahead and make a rough sketch of a parabola with a vertex at the origin that opens up, because this information will help us determine our focus, directrix, and so on. And later we'll make a more accurate sketch. So we know the vertex is at the origin, so it would be this point here. And we know the parabola opens up, so it would look something like this. Now the reason this helps is since the parabola opens up, the focus, or this point here, must be above the vertex or inside the parabola. And it'll be the opposite value of a units above the vertex. And since a is equal to 5 halves or 2.5, that means the focus would be up 2.5 units, or right here. We also know because the parabola opens up, the directrix will be a horizontal line 2.5 or 5 half units below the vertex, so the directrix would have to pass through this point here. So let's go ahead and sketch the directrix. So now let's find the coordinates of the focus and the equation of the directrix. Well, if we know that the focus is 2.5 or 5 half units above the vertex, we can just look at the coordinate plane to determine the coordinates, or add 2.5 or 5 halves to the y-coordinate of the vertex. The focus would have coordinates 0, 5 halves, or 0, 2.5. And then because the directrix is 2.5 units below the vertex, and it's a horizontal line, the equation of this horizontal line, just by looking at the coordinate plane, would be y equals negative 2.5, or y equals negative 5 halves. Now for the equation of the axis, because our parabola opens up or down, and the vertex is at the origin, the axis of symmetry would be this vertical line here, which is always going to be the y-axis, which has the equation x equals 0. You could think of this as a line that cuts the parabola in half, or if we were to fold the parabola across that line, it would match up perfectly with the other half. And then finally for the last part, we want to find the length and the endpoints of the latus rectum, sometimes called the focal diameter. Well, the length of this segment is equal to the absolute value of 4a, and since 4a is equal to 10, the length of the latus rectum is 10 units. And since the focus is the midpoint of this segment, and it's parallel to the directrix, that means one endpoint would be 5 units to the right of the focus, or this point here, and the other endpoint would be 5 units to the left of the focus, or this point here. So again, just by looking at the coordinate plane, we know the point on the left would have coordinates negative 5, 5 halves, or negative 5, 2.5. And the endpoint on the right would have coordinates 5, 5 halves, or 5, 2.5. So now we'll sketch the latus rectum, which will then help us make a more accurate sketch. We know the parabola opens up, has a vertex at the origin, and must pass through the two endpoints of the latus rectum, which means we can make a more accurate graph. The parabola would look something like this. Okay, hope you found this explanation helpful. We'll take a look at another example in the next video.